Hey, welcome back. Today, I'm going to teach you how to install some Skyrim mods. So, to start off, you want to go to your address bar in whichever browser you want, and you want to type in. I'm just going to do a search for Nexus. And do we get it? Yes, we do. So here we go to www.nexusmods.com/Skyrim. There will be a link in the description. And here we go. We're straight in. Now, if you end up on the homepage, so that would be just nexusmods.com. Then you can see all of the lists of games. Look at that. But we just want Skyrim, so let's go to that. And here we can see the hot files recently. But we don't want that yet. First of all, we want to make an account. Now, this is something that people have asked me before. Which is why I'm making another video, because this is one of the places that people get stuck on, if you'll believe. So we go to create an account here. And it is here. Register. Select any packages you would like to purchase. You'll be directed to the payment screen once your account has been created and you've logged in. If you do not want to buy premium, simply skip this step by pressing click create account at the bottom of the page. So just don't select any of this stuff and click create account. There you go. You don't need to buy anything. Okay. Then you just make your account as normal and it should work totally fine and should not charge you anything. So if you're having problems and thought you had to pay, you don't. Just go to the bottom, create a new account without taking anything. If you do want to pay, feel free to. It'll help the people who make this, and it'll make your downloads faster. But I'm going to log in and join you again. Okie dokie. Once you've got your account ready, you want to download the Nexus Mod Manager. Now, this will let you install all your mods automatically. So we want to go up to here and click Install NMM. It may be a different version to mine, depending on when you do it. And you want to select the one for your operating system. If you've got XP, if you're running Windows XP, then you want that one. But for most people, you're just going to go to download for Vista, Win7, Win8. Okay, so once that's downloaded, you want to click it, let it run. Now it should. Come on. Here we go. It should come up with user account control, and you press yes. If it doesn't, you want to go to show in folder and make sure to run it as administrator. Basically, that's a pretty good rule. If something doesn't work on your PC, try running as administrator. So, setup language, English. Next. Accept. Next. 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 Okay, we do want a desktop option. I do not want a quick launch. And I do want all of this stuff. So that's fine. Leave it how it is. Install. And now it's going to grab everything. And launch. Let us do it. And now, this is a scary screen. So you may start having a heart attack, but it's fine. Okay, because this is just searching for any games that you might be able to mod on your computer. So instantly it's found Skyrim. So what you want to do is you want to tick the mods that you want. So it hasn't found any of these. So all I need to do is tick Skyrim. And once it's done that, I can say stop searching. And there we go. So it's find Skyrim. That's good. And okay. There we go. So select the game you would like to manage. And Skyrim. Here we go. Choose the mod directory where you would like to store your Skyrim mods. So now you can change this if you want. Some mods do take up a lot of storage, so you might feel like you want to. I'm just going to leave it on C. If you do want to change it, just click this little button here and select the folder. But I'm fine with my C drive, so I'm going to click Finish. And here we go, laddies. Look at this. It's loading up. And hopefully, it will find all my old mods. Come on, fingers crossed. Recently, some spam emails have been going around. There you go, kids. Don't read spam emails. Never do it. And there we go. It's found all my old mods. For you, it will be empty. Unless you already have mods. And you can see you've got Launch Skyrim up here. Now, we need to do some things. First, bottom left, you need to click this little man. Okay, if it's red, click it. And then you need to log in. Okay, so once you've put in the details that you had up here to log in to your Nexus mod account on the website, and you've put that into the manager, you should have a little green icon. Now, it might work if you don't log in, but I'm not sure, and it's probably best to just do it if you can, so as to not cause any problems. So, now we need to... I'm just checking settings in here, but I think it's mostly good. So now we can find a mod that we want to download. So on the front page of, you know, .com/Skyrim, you can see all the new and hot files. Now, to find the most downloaded, which is probably what you'll want, seeming as you're new, you want to go to Files, Top Files, and you can see them here. So there you go. One is SkyUI, the unofficial Skyrim patch. Da-da-da-da. So you can do all of this. I have got all of these. So I'm going to go to a smaller mod, which is a quality world map. And it should be pretty fast to download too. So on description, we can see all the information about it. We can see how to install it, but it's fine because you've got this video. And any other information you need. If your mods don't work, you want to check here to see if it says you need something that you don't. But I'm looking, and I think we have everything we need. So we can just get on with going to files and looking for the file we want. So there's an installer, there's an add-on, there's a Solstheim map. I don't want that. I just want to go to download with manager, and that will put a little white buffer load wheel, and then this starts flashing, and look, there we go. It's downloading. And has it downloaded already? No, it hasn't. Now I'm just going to cancel this because, actually, if that works, then it will appear in your mod list here with all the other ones. If that doesn't work for you, first of all, you want to go to Settings, Download Options, click this Fix It thing. So you want to close Chrome and click this Fix It thing and see if that fixes it for you. If it doesn't, you want to try to download manually. So next to this button, you can go download manually. It will start downloading here. And if we can see, we can right click this and go to show in folder. And that's going to show us where it is on our computer. And we can see it here. It's in downloads. So now if we go to the Nexus Mod Manager, we click this little add mod from file button. And we click this. It adds it just as it would normally. So those are your two options. You can just download automatically or with manager, and there you go, it's in our list. Either way, it will be just the same as it is here in this list. It'll have a little red X next to it, which means it's not activated. So to activate it, you want to click the green button here that says activate the selected mod, and are we doing it? It's installing. Here we go. It's come up with a little installer. Yep, I want roads. Sure, do not install, install, and go. Look at that. Done. If that did not work for you, if you go into Skyrim and that doesn't work, first thing you want to do is find your shortcut. You want to right-click it, and you want to go to Run as Administrator. Okay? Let that happen, da-da-da, and it should open it as Administrator. And now, you want to try that process again. Okay? If that doesn't work, then you want to go to the mod page and make sure that there's nothing that you've missed on here. You know, if it says, oh, you need this mod to make it work, da da da. You want to look through the install, make sure that doesn't work. If that doesn't work, if it's an armor mod, those don't just appear in your inventory. You actually have to either find the armor in game, craft it yourself, or spawn it in. If you want to know how to spawn in armor, you need to use the command prompt. There's a tutorial in the description. So now you have successfully installed your mod, and you can just click Launch Skyrim to go. So that should work for pretty much every mod out there. Although some mods that are a bit more complicated, like a lot of quest mods, do need some certain things. Like some of them need SkyUI and some of them need SKSE. So SkyUI is just another mod that you can download. It's pretty easy. It's the most downloaded mod. So you can do that just like we did in this video. If you want to download SKSE, I'd say 1 in 10 mods uses it. So if you want to find out how to install SKSE, it's a bit different, but there's a link in the description that will show you how to do that. And if you want to get some ideas of some good Skyrim mods to download, lots of links in the description of my 3 Skyrim mod series where I'll show you some mods and whether they're worth downloading. So yeah, thank you for watching, and feel free to leave a like and subscribe like on the next episode of Skyrim Tutorial! What? How? So, yeah, they do definitely give you quite the performance drop. And you will see random cows walking around where they don't usually, but apart from that, lightning fart. Okay, sorry, Sigurd. Right, now all we need to do is find a dog to treat. And there's one. He's chasing this kid. He's scared for his life. He's crying. Look at him.